At-home rapid tests, or antigen tests, can be a valuable tool if you use them correctly. Here are three things you need to know. First, what do rapid tests actually tell us?
Antigen tests is one of the most underutilized tools of this pandemic. And the reason I say that is because they're really good at telling us if we're infectious or not. This is very different than PCR tests. And PCR tests just tell us if we have the virus in our system or not. It doesn't tell us whether we're contagious or not.
At what point after symptoms or exposure should you use a rapid test?
Antigen tests are really great at detecting infectious disease. Omicron threw a little wrench in it, though, for us, because what the variant created was that we become symptomatic even earlier, meaning that sometimes the antigen tests will not detect a positive case early in disease. And so we recommend that once you become symptomatic, wait about 24 hours to use that antigen test. And then if you're still negative, retest again. So we ensure that we decrease the number of false negatives as much as possible.
When should you rely on rapid tests and when should you get a PCR test?
At-home testing is a really great tool to use to break transmission chains, especially if you just came back from a high-risk activity. For example, maybe you went to a concert and you don't want to bring the virus back to your family, your home. Or if the other way around, if you're at home and you're going to go visit someone that's vulnerable, for example, going to a nursing home, testing that morning right before your activity or right after your activity and thereafter in a cadence will be very helpful in knowing whether you're infectious or not. I think antigen tests should be really leveraged for exiting isolation. The current recommendation right now is 5 days after you're symptomatic, you can leave isolation. But what we're seeing is that people are still contagious 7, 10, 12 days later after the first symptomatic disease. And so we should really use this tool for exit to isolation.